I'm up.
It's not what you did, son. It's who you did it to.
Nobody?
That nobody. Is John Wick.
What if the worst possible man in existence could find salvation? And what happens to that man? Does he change? The idea of John Wick came from the fact is, what if the devil found salvation? Would it be true to his core? Would he remain that way even when the source of his salvation is ripped from him?
John Wick's about a man apart. What happens when, you know, you've lost everything in the world you care about? And how low, how dark will you go?
I lost everything. That dog was a final gift from my dying wife.
John is definitely a symbol of duality, for sure. It's, I wouldn't say good versus evil or anything like that. I would just say between what people have to endure and what people want to endure. You know, John has many things that he does endure. And John has a couple things that he doesn't want to endure, and I think we all have those things.
You working again?
No, just sorting some stuff out.
And I think this speaks to the maybe the attraction of the story and the script, and maybe for the audience member. I always thought of it as being kind of Old Testament in a revenge kind of way. But when people take things from you that you treasure and love, there's a violence that erupts. And John doesn't temper his violence.
We wanted to make two separate worlds. We had John Wick's world, where he was in love with this woman and he's living like a normal life, and it's very, very organic and cinema verite real. And then once he goes into this assassin hyper real world, I mean, it becomes like a graphic novel.
If we speak about it graphic novel-y, you know, I think it's got the humor of hard-boiled dialogue. You know, the graphic novels, the images and framing that we've come to think of graphic novels.
People keep asking if I'm back. Yeah, I'm thinking I'm back.